Henrietta Lacks was an African-American woman who lost her life to cancer, but the cells of her tumor became the source of the HeLa strain, which aided in a number of medical advancements. She was born on August 1, 1920 in Roanoke, Virginia. At 21, she married David Day Lacks and moved to Baltimore shortly after with their two children. They would go on to have three more. Then, in January of 1951, the 30-year-old mother of five experienced abnormal bleeding and tremendous pain in her uterus. It was confirmed that she had cervical cancer, so Henrietta went through radiation and treatment for nearly a year. But the tumor was aggressive and caused her an indescribable amount of pain. So the doctors took a piece of it to biopsy and then cut off a second piece to send to a Dr. George Guy, a researcher with the institution. And on October 4th, 1951, she died at the age of 31, leaving behind five children, including a 15-month-old daughter. But meanwhile, at Dr. George Guy's lab, Guy and many other researchers at the time from other institutions were attempting to grow human cells in a dish. But every time they tried, the cells died. The cells from Henrietta Lacks' tumor didn't die. In fact, they thrived, doubling in size every 24 hours, which he called the HeLa strain. H-E from Henrietta and L-A for Lacks. So eventually, her cells were in hundreds of labs. These cells were then infected with the polio virus, and scientists were able to test Jonas Salk's vaccine. But it wasn't just polio. Her cells contributed to salmonella treatment, HIV treatment, gene mapping, cancer treatments, HPV vaccines, just to name a few. And all of this went on without a word to her family. That is, until the 1970s. See, the HeLa strain was extremely aggressive. It had been contaminating other non-HeLa strains in the labs. So scientists, in order to sort the strains out, reached out to her family for blood samples. But when they reached out, the scientists didn't do a very good job explaining the whole situation. They made it sound like they'd cloned Henrietta without her permission and that there were Henriettas out there living in the world. Unsurprisingly, that was really unsettling to her family. On top of that, much of this research was happening in for-profit labs, using clones of their mother's cells. Her genome, too, was published online in 2013 without her family's permission, raising a laundry list of ethical questions about research patients and their genetic material. But at least now, her name is known. Johns Hopkins and many other research institutions have publicly recognized Lacks' contribution to science and research. Henrietta Lacks died from her tumor, and she died in great pain. But her cells went on to save more people than we can count, perhaps most notably saving women across the world from the very same disease that killed her. And for that, we owe her a great deal.